إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وسلم تسليمًا كثيرًا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالًا كثيرًا ونساءً، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله. Indeed, the most truthful of speech and the best of words are the words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم. And the best guidance is the guidance of our beloved messenger Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. وشر الأمور محدثاتها. And the worst of affairs are those things we newly invent into this religion of ours. وكل محدثة بدعة. And everything we newly invent into this religion of ours is an innovation. وكل بدعة ضلالة. And every innovation is misguidance and it leads astray. وَكُلَّ ضَلَالَةٍ فِي النَّارِ. Every going astray, every misguidance is in the hellfire. ثُمَّ أَمَّا بَعْدُ. My dear brothers in Islam, when we look at the world today, we're seeing earthquakes, hurricanes, tornadoes, wars, bloodshed, promiscuity, lewdness, immorality, disease after disease, and now a pandemic that has taken the world by storm, this COVID-19. Allah has warned us and given us many signs over and over again to worship Him and to praise Him, to follow the pure deen, to return to Him when we err and when we sin, to beg for forgiveness and make the tawbah an-nasuha, that sincere repentance. Yet we still do not prioritize Allah like we should. We still do not prioritize Islam like we should. The opportunity after opportunity to help in the way of Allah, to do good deeds, to donate to His cause, to help others in need. Many of these opportunities, we lose them. We lose out on them. They're squandered. They're lost. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He says, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا إِن تَنْصُرُ اللَّهِ يَنْصُرُكُمْ وَيُثَبِّتْ أَقْدَامَكُمْ. Allah says, what means, O you who believe. Again, anyone who wants to be from the believers should always take keenness to these ayat that begins with Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu. If you help in the cause of Allah, Allah doesn't need our help. But if you aid His deen by following it, by having good character and manners so people learn the deen of Allah through you, if you do this, then Allah will help you and He will make your foothold firm. He will make you firm upon this deen. ثُمَّ قَالَ اللَّهُ تَبَارَكَ الَّذِي بِيَدِهِ الْمُلْكُ وَهُوَ عَلَى كُلِّ شَيْءٍ قَدِيرٌ الذي خلق الموت والحياة ليبلوكم أيكم أحسن عملا وهو العزيز الغفور. Allah says, what means, blessed is He in whose hand is the dominion and He is able to do all things. Allah is the one who has created life and death, that He may test you, not in who will become more wealthy, not in who will become stronger, not in who will achieve the best of looks, but He will test you in good deeds. He will test you to see who will be the best in good deeds. And He is the Almighty, the Oft-Forgiving. In knowing this and looking at what Allah and His Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam gave us and what His companions radiallahu anhum wa ardahum did, we realize that we should frequently remember the shortness of this life and that death is a heartbeat away. And this was something that the Sahaba constantly were always talking about, speaking about, lecturing about, reminding one another about. It's the fact that death can come at any time. Allah says, كُلُّ نَفْسٍ ذَائِقَةُ الْمَوْتِ وَإِنَّمَا تُوَفَّوْنَ أُجُورُكُمْ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ فَمَنْ زُحْزِحَ عَنِ النَّارِ وَأُدْخِلَ الْجَنَّةَ فَقَدْ فَازْ وَمَا الْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا إِلَّا مَتَاعُ الْغُرُورِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He says, what means, every soul will taste death. No one is going to escape it. And only on the day of resurrection will you be paid your wages in full. And whoever is removed from the fire, saved from Jahannam, and they enter and are admitted into paradise, into Jannah, this is the one who is indeed successful. The life of this world is only an enjoyment of deception. So success comes when our feet are in Jannah and we've been saved from the hellfire. And this happens regardless of the color of your skin. It happens regardless of your lineage. It happens regardless of your wealth status. It happens regardless of your nationality or the language you speak. It happens regardless of your education level. Success comes when you enter Jannah. And only then can you say you've been successful in this life. And the life of this world is only an illusion of deception and an enjoyment of deception. It's not saying do not enjoy this life in what is halal. It's not saying do not earn wealth and buy things that you like. Just prioritize the akhirah and realize that this life can fade on you like the sun sets every day, fading in the west. It will fade. And then you will only have your deeds to face Allah with. So every soul shall taste that death. كُلُّ نَفْسٍ ذَائِقَةُ الْمَوْتِ ثُمَّ إِلَيْنَا تُرْجَعُونَ. And then unto us, unto Allah, you will be returned. وَالَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ لَنُبَوِّئَنَّهُمْ مِنَ الْجَنَّةِ غُرْفَةً تَجْرِي مِنْ تَحْتِهَا الْأَنْهَارُ خَالِدِينَ فِيهَا نِعْمَ أَجْرُ الْعَامِلِينَ. Allah says what means, and those who believe in the oneness of Allah, those who are firm believers in Tawheed and follow the aqeedah of our pious predecessors, and they do righteous deeds, to them we're going to give them lofting dwellings in Jannah, underneath which rivers flow, to live therein forever. Excellent is the reward for the workers. And this is the key. The ones who work in the way of Allah, not just selfishly, not just you establish your prayers, and you give the minimum of your zakat and the likes of this, but you're constantly working in the way of Allah, looking for good deeds to do. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He says, قُلْ إِنَّ الْمَوْتَ الَّذِي تَفِرُّونَ مِنْهُ فَإِنَّهُ مُلَاقِيكُمْ ثُمَّ تُرَدُّونَ إِلَى عَالِمِ الْغَيْبِ وَالشَّهَادَةِ فَيُنَبِّئُكُمْ بِمَا كُنْتُمْ تَعْمَلُونَ. Allah says what means, say to them, verily the death from which you flee will surely meet you. Run away, build a stone building and put yourself in the middle of it. When death comes to you, it's coming to you and you can't escape it. Surely you will be sent back to meet Allah, the knower of the all-knower of the seen and the unseen, and He will tell you what you used to do. And Abi Hurairah radiallahu anhu qala Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam, أكثر ذكر هذا من اللذات يعني الموت. This hadith that we find, which is authentic, Hassan in the Sunan of Ibn Majah, the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wasallam, he said, frequently remember the destroyer of pleasures. Remember as much as you can the reality, the fact, which always brings an end to all worldly pleasures, to all worldly fun, to all worldly enjoyment. And this thing is death. This is not pessimism. This is the reality, the inevitable journey we will all go through in this life. No one will live forever. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He tells us about those who didn't listen to this. Allah warns us, if you don't listen and take heed and remind yourself of death and do work, righteous deeds and work deeds of goodness, then you'll be on the losing end. Allah says, وَهُمْ يَصْطَرِخُونَ فِيهَا رَبَّنَا أَخْرِجْنَا نَعْمَلْ صَالِحًا غَيْرَ الَّذِي كُنَّا نَعْمَلْ أَوَلَمْ نُعَمِّرْكُمْ مَا يَتَذَكَّرُ فِيهِ وَتَذَكَّرَ وَجَاءَكُمُ النَّذِيرُ فَذُوقُوا فَمَا لِلظَّالِمِينَ مِنْ نَصِيرٍ. And Allah says what means, therein, at the time those in Jahannam, in the hellfire, will cry out, our Lord, bring us out so that we can do righteous deeds, not the evil deeds we did when you gave us that first life. And Allah will reply, did we not give you a life long enough? Did we not give you enough of a life to do good deeds and stay away from evil? Did we not give this to you so that whoever would receive admonition could receive it? We were warned. Every nation was warned. Every nation was sent a messenger and a prophet to give them that warning. And the warner came to you. So taste your evil, the evil of your deeds. For the zalimun, those who are polytheists and wrongdoers, there is no helper. Allah says, وَلِلَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا بِرَبِّهِمْ عَذَابُ جَهَنَّمَ وَبِئْسَ الْمَصِيرُ. And for those who disbelieve in their Lord is the torment of Jahannam. The worst indeed is that destination. إِذَا أُلْقُوا فِيهَا سَمْعُوا لَهَا شَهِيقًا وَهِيَ تَفُورُ. When they are cast therein, they will hear the terrible drawing out, the terrible drawing in of its breath as it blazes forth. تكاد تميز من الغيظ كلما ألقي فيها فوج سألهم خزنتها ألم يأتكم نذير. It almost bursts up with fury. Every time a group is cast therein, its keeper will ask to the people of the hellfire, did a warner not come to you? Did not someone come? Did not some message reach you to warn you that this would be your destination if you disobeyed, or you were disobedient, or you did evil instead of doing good? قالوا بلى قد جاءنا نذير فكذبنا وقلنا ما نزل الله من شيء إلا إن أنتم إلا في ضلال كبير. Allah says, what means? They will say, yes, indeed, a warner did come to us, but we belied him, we ignored him, we didn't take what he said seriously, we didn't follow what he taught, and said, Allah never sent down anything of revelation, you are only in great error. Nowadays, we find even those who say, La ilaha illallah, denying the sunnah of the Messenger of Allah, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, trying to belie his sunnah, trying to ignore it, trying to say that it has falsities or errors, or that we can't trust it, wal'ayadu billah. And this is a crime, and you could fall into this destination answering Allah from the hellfire. وَقَالُوا لَوْ كُنَّا نَسْمَعُ أَوْ نَعْقِلُ مَا كُنَّا فِي أَصْحَابَ السَّعِيرِ. And they will say, had we but listened and used our intelligence, we would not have been amongst the dwellers of the blazing fire. فَاَعْتَرَفُوا بِذَنْبِهِمْ فَصُحْقًا لِأَصْحَابِ السَّعِيرِ. Then they will confess their sin, so away with the dwellers of the blazing fire. This will be the abode, because they belied the sins of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It was narrated from Ibn Umar radiallahu anhuma, أنه قال, كنت مع رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم فجاءه رجل من الأنصار فسلم على النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم ثم قال يا رسول الله أي المؤمنين أفضل؟ قال أحسنهم خلقا. قال فأي المؤمنين أكيس؟ قال أكثرهم للموت ذكرا وأحسنهم لما بعده استعداد أولئك الأكياس. This hadith, which is Hasan in the Sunan of Ibn Majah, the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam was with Ibn Umar, and Ibn Umar, he said, I was with him, and a man from amongst the Ansar came and greeted him and said, O Messenger of Allah, which of the believers are best? And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said something we always hear, yet we still fail to do. The one who's best is the one who's best in their akhlaq, in their manners, in their character, in their behaviors. So then he asked, which of them is the wisest? Which of the believers is the wisest? And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said, it's the one who remembers death the most and is best in preparing for it. Those are the ones who are the wisest. So death is something that the Muslim should always be thinking about, preparing for, scaring themselves with, so that they obey Allah and His Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam. أقول قولي هذا واستغفر الله لي ولكم ادعو الله يغفر لكم ذنوبكم. إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونستهدي ونصلي ونسلم على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما كثيرا وبعد. My dear brothers in Islam, remembering death is not a pessimistic way of living. It is something we're encouraged to do so that we could be wise with how we live our life. We need to remember it because every soul will inevitably reach that destination. It won't miss anybody. Allah is telling us to wake up, to save ourselves. We're given countless warnings, after warning, after warning, to not commit shirk, yet we still find those committing it. Even though Allah said, إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يَغْفِرُ أَن يُشْرَكَ بِهِ وَيَغْفِرُ مَا دُونَ ذَلِكَ لِمَن يَشَاءُ. Even though Allah said that He will not forgive the sin of shirk, but He'll forgive any sin other than that. We're constantly reminded to not break off the prayer, and to not leave it. Why? Because our Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said, فَمَنْ تَرَكَهَا فَقَدْ كَفَرْ. The one who leaves the prayer has committed kufr or disbelief. We're constantly reminded and warned about paying our zakat so that you don't put yourself in a major punishment in your grave and on the day of resurrection. We're constantly reminded to fast Ramadan, to make hajj, to not engage in عقوق الوالدين and قول الزور وشهادة الزور, to not engage in disobedience to the parents and uttering falsehood or witnessing falsehood. عن أبي بكرة رضي الله عنه قال قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم ألا أنبئكم بأكبر الكبائر. The messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he asked the companions, should I not tell you what is the biggest of the biggest sins? What is the most major of the major sins? قَالُوا بَلَا يَا رَسُولَ اللَّهِ. They said, of course, tell us, O messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And he responded, الْإِشْرَاكُ بِاللَّهِ وَعْقُوكُ الْوَالِدَيْنِ. It is shirk with Allah and disobedience to the parents. And then he mentioned, وَكَانَ مُتَّكِئًا فَجَلَسَ فَقَالَ أَلَا وَقَوْلُ الزُّورِ وَشَهَادَةِ الزُّورِ. أَلَا وَقَوْلُ الزُّورِ وَشَهَادَةِ الزُّورِ. فما زال يقولها حتى قلت لا يسكت. This hadith in Sahih al-Bukhari, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he asked, what is the most major of sins? Do you want to know? They said, tell us, O Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He said, it is to commit shirk and to disobey your parents, to disobey your parents and to be undutiful to them, to not serve them and help them out. And then he sat up from his sitting position and he said, and I warn you against giving forged statements, false statements, and being a false witness. And he repeated it and repeated it. And the Prophet ﷺ kept saying it until we thought that he would not stop warning us about this. We are warned to not engage in riba, to not backbite, to not slander. It's like eating the flesh of your brother. To not take the riba. It's like war with Allah and His Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam. To not engage yourself in immorality like homosexuality and the likes. To not find yourself as men, yani imitating women and women imitating men. We were warned about the rights that we have to maintain. The right that Allah has on us. The rights over that our parents have on us. That our children have over us. That our spouses have on us. That our bodies have on us. That the orphans have on us and the likes. عن أبي هريرة رضي الله عنه قال قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم اللهم إني أحرج حق الضعفين اليتيم والمرأة. رواه ابن ماجه وهذا حديث حسن. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, he said, oh Allah, bear witness that I have warned the people about the failure to fulfill the rights of the two weak ones, the women and the orphans. And yet many of us, we live a life where we constantly don't even care about the women. We deny them their rights. We're abusive towards them physically, verbally, whatever it may be, emotionally. And the same for the orphans, constantly forgotten. So wake up, ya akhwani fillah. Smell the coffee that this life is short and death is approaching. We have one life to prove to Allah that we deserve His forgiveness, that we deserve His mercy. So strive hard and stop being lazy with regard to your deen and stop being lazy when it comes to serving Allah. So many of us will tire ourselves to go and have fun, tire ourselves seeking entertainment, tire ourselves to make an extra dollar or two, tire ourselves to enjoy this dunya. So many can help with learning, teaching, spreading the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, helping to advance the cause of Allah, but they choose not to, deceiving themselves with the fact that, well, I pray and I fast and I go to the masjid, so I have taqwa and the likes of this. Do not fall into this situation that we are about to mention, inshaAllah. And I pray to Allah that none of us, none of our families, none of our loved ones, or this ummah is in this boat. Allah said, وَمَنْ أَعْرَضَ عَنْ ذِكْرِي فَإِنَّ لَهُ مَعِيشَةٍ ضَنْكَ وَنَحْشُرُهُ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ أَعْمَى. Allah says what means, but whoever turns away from my reminder, whoever turns away from the Quran and the Sunnah, whoever does not believe in this Quran and Sunnah, whoever does not act upon the Quran and the Sunnah, verily for him is a life of hardship. Verily for him is a life of hardship. And we will raise him up blind on the day of resurrection. قَالَ رَبِّي لِمَا حَشَرْتَنِي أَعْمَى وَكُنْتُ بَصِيرًا. Oh my Lord, the person will say, oh my Lord, how have you resurrected me blind, but in the dunya I could see. Allah will say, قَالَ كَذَلِكَ أَتَتْكَ آيَاتُنَا فَنَسِيتَهَا. Allah will say, like this, our ayat, our proofs, our evidences, our verses, our lessons, our signs, our revelations, our warnings, they all came to you, but you disregarded them. You paid them no regard. You closed your eyes to them. You plugged your ears to them. You turned away from them. You left them. You did not ponder upon them. وَكَذَلِكَ الْيَوْمَ تُنْسَى. And so on this day, I'm going to neglect you. Allah will say, on this day, you're neglected. On this day, you're not going to be remembered. On this day, I will pay no regard to what you are in need of me. Do not put yourself in that situation. Do not deny the meeting of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It is real, it is true. Do not be in the situation where you're told by Allah, وَكَذَلِكَ الْيَوْمَ تُنْسَى. And this day you are forgotten and you are given no regard by me. We ask Allah to make us of those who fear death and know death. Know that it exists and inevitably it will come to every one of us. And we ask Allah to make us those who fear Him with respect to our deen and the rights that people, everyone has over us. Make us those who are righteous and make us those inhabitants of Jannah and save us from the punishment of Jahannam. اللهم اغفر للمسلمين والمسلمات والمؤمنين والمؤمنات الأحياء منهم والأموات إنك أنت سميع قريب مجيب الدعوات يا مقلب القلوب ثبت قلوبنا على دينك يا مقلب القلوب ثبت قلوبنا على دينك يا مقلب القلوب ثبت قلوبنا على دينك سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون وسلام على المرسلين والحمد لله رب العالمين.